Standing here in a little corner of my jar-filled windowsill is this strange glass box, encasing another glass box containing life. There's a good chance you've never seen this project before because it all started 7 years ago when this channel reached 4,000 subscribers. To celebrate, I decided to make this monstrosity, an ecosphere inside of another ecosphere, one ecosystem enclosing another. After taking some materials from a nearby ecosystem, it was assembly time. The outer ecosystem got this plant, Limnophila heterophylla, to act as a biological filter, cleaning the water, as well as providing the animal inhabitants with oxygen and food. Fulfilling this role in the inner ecosystem would be Cryptocora and Wentii. Of course, algae already present in the water and sediment will play a similar part in the ecology of these ecosystems. After sealing both the jars airtight, they had both become closed ecosystems. A small world existing in a slightly bigger world, existing in a considerably larger world. Quite dark at first, but a day later things had cleared up and were looking much brighter, literally. Due to refraction, it looks like the smaller jar should never be able to fit inside the larger jar, but that's not true, of course. So, what animal life did we start out with? Well, there were a lot of daphnia and also some copepods, mostly small ones, but there was one really big daphnia carrying eggs. Also abundant were boogie worms, Tubifex tubifex. Fun fact about boogie worms, many years ago I started referring to Tubifex as boogie worms and have continued to do so over the years. Nowadays, if you look up boogie worms in any search engine, you will get information about Tubifex worms. Apparently, I've had influence. That's awesome. Anyway, I digress. Also present in the ecosystem were two species of ostracod, or sea shrimp, a large one and a small one. Back then, I mostly filmed the larger species because I hadn't seen it that much, while the smaller species was present in almost all freshwater systems I had made. This big one went absolutely berserk. Looking back at these clips, it is really difficult to say whether these animals were also present in the inner ecosystem, but since they were made in the same fashion, I think it's reasonable to assume that they were. A little over a month later, the Limnophila heterophylla had grown a lot, almost completely taking over the outer ecosystem. All of the glass surfaces were covered by algae, making it difficult to see what's going on. But the plant in the inner jar seemed to be doing okay, and many little critters can be seen swimming around. So that was almost 7 years ago. In the meantime, I did film it, once, half a year ago. And I can tell you it hasn't changed that much in half a year, because this is what it looks like nowadays, 7 years since it was made, to the day. I didn't even plan this. I made it so long ago that I didn't even remember what season it was, let alone the date. But I just felt it was time for an update. Must be some cosmic coincidence. Unfortunately, the cosmic coincidentiality did not extend to the Life in Jar subscriber count. It would have been nice if it coincided with the 400,000 subscriber mark, but maybe some unsubscribed viewers could change that. So, this is the state of the 7-year-old ecosystem. Two things are immediately noticeable. The plants in both ecosystems are gone, and there is still animal activity. Normally, for projects that have been running this long, I'm able to show you what happened over the years. But in this case, I don't really have any footage. Of course, I can tell you whatever I remember. At some point, an aquatic snake appeared. It was quite large, not able to stretch its body, and therefore had to resort to swimming in circles. At some point, it grew so large that it met its own tail. And then it started eating itself. In just a few days, it had completely disappeared, leaving no trace at all. The problem with not having any video footage of what happened is that the viewer has to resort to imagination and that I, like a visual aid, to jog my memory. Without it, I just might misremember things. Here is the inner ecosystem. The plant has completely disappeared, and near the edges of the jar are bits of biofilm that seem to have grown on and fell off the glass. This biofilm likely consists of bacteria and algae. I've noticed in many aquatic systems contained in glass, whether they are closed or not, that cycles seem to occur in which biofilm grows on the glass and then falls off for whatever reason, only to grow back again. That is the reason sometimes the glass of my jars is really hard to see through, and other times crystal clear. We'll get to the animals in the inner jar later on in the video, but I wonder if the apparent lack of activity in the jar is due to light deficiency. I do actually remember that the plant in the inner jar died really quickly, while the plant in the outer jar was doing really well. The cryptocorine I planted in there has the tendency to drop all its leaves once it is replanted and then growing back new ones. But to do that it needs light, which might have been mostly blocked by the prolifically growing plants of the outer ecosystem. Let's look at the outer ecosystem. Here too we have a lack of plants, but we've also seen a lot of animal activity. The animal life needs to be sustained by some sort of primary producer. In the case of this ecosystem, these thread algae fulfill that role. These are responsible for producing oxygen and sugars for the animal life. As a rule of thumb, algae are usually more photosynthetically efficient than plants, as well as often more resilient, so it's not strange that they would survive for much longer. Add that to the fact that they're more easily consumed by these small ostracods than plants are, and you've got an excellent primary producer for the ecosystem. The inner system also seems to lack any multicellular algae. These algae are growing only on the side directly facing the window and not throughout the rest of the jar, further suggesting that light is a limiting factor. In the algae we see all kinds of critters crawling around. These are ostracods or sea shrimp. There are still the same two species in here as there were at the start, and here you can see them next to each other. Here you see one crawling in the layer of sediment, which you might have noticed has grown considerably. Pretty much all the organic matter present since the start of the ecosystem that is not currently algae or an ostracod or a microbe has turned into this brown sludge that is now covering the original sediment in a layer of a few centimeters thick. As we've established before, these ostracods are true masters of survival, being the longest lived animals in nearly all my ecosystems. Just look at this one. Alright, then don't move, jerk. I'm trying to make a video over here. There's also this blob growing on the glass, which has actually grown a bit in the last half year. The string of algae on the glass is actually on the inside of the jar, so there is some algae in there, but it doesn't look very healthy. If we look above the waterline, we see some slimy greenish growth on the glass, the result of some kind of biological activity. But we also see that the top of the inner jar is no longer submerged. This is not because of a leak in the outer jar and evaporation though, the cause can actually be found in the inner jar. Being submerged for so long, the lid has started to somewhat disintegrate, causing the air from the inner jar to escape to the outer jar. Who knows what kind of chemicals leaked into the water? Not enough to kill the ostracods, that for sure. So, about the animal life in the inner jar. If it's there, it's not much. It's quite difficult to see with the naked eye, and even more so with a camera, but I am quite sure I saw something moving on the inside of the glass. It looked like a very tiny ostracod, but unfortunately I haven't been able to film it properly. Even if it is there, there's hardly any life in the inner ecosphere. And unfortunately I have no clue how long that has been the case for, other than that the plant in it died very quickly, so maybe it's been dead or near dead for a long time. This was probably caused by a combination of being a small ecosystem, The smaller the volume, the less buffering capacity it has, as well as receiving little light. The outer ecosystem seems to have found a stable balance, with the algae and the ostracods sustaining each other. They too live in a relatively small ecosystem, especially since a considerable portion of its volume is dead space, so to say. Even so, it is quite impressive for an ecosystem to be completely sealed off airtight, existing solely self-sufficiently for such a long time. For now, it's time to put it back in its little corner of my jar-filled windowsill. Thank you so much for watching and listening to me rambling on about some old jar. See you in the next video. Goodbye. We'll be right back.